Good morning, Impact iKids. Mr. Anthony here with another message for you this Sunday. I'm glad that you're here. Listen, I've been praying for you. I hope all is well. I hope that you're doing well. I hope you had an amazing week. Listen, I'm excited about the message that we're about to hear today. Stay tuned, stay ready, get ready, because it's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome. But before we get in, I want to continue to hear from you guys. How are you? How are you doing? Continue to email. Listen, we are back in person. So if you can make it in person, please do. If you can't, please continue to watch the messages at home. Listen, either way, you're going to be blessed. Either way, you're growing in Christ. And that's the most important thing. But reach out to us. I want to hear from you via email. Or if you're coming in person, I can't wait to see you. But until then, let's get into this message. Let's get it. You know what I'm about to say. You already know what I'm about to say. Go, iKidz. Woo! iKidz, let's get it.
Sometimes I ask myself,
who am I really?
Hang on for the loop!
4, 3, 2, 1.
And I'm Jamie, and this month we're going to be talking a lot about you.
Me?
Yes, you and me and everyone and these people back here.
Show them what we're talking about. Hey! So this month we are talking a lot about identity, all the things that make you... you.
Let's be clear. Who you are is anything but ordinary.
Yeah, you might just think you're a regular old human beat-bopping from normal event to normal event.
But the Bible has an out-of-the-ordinary description of who you are.
It says you are made in the image of God.
That's not ordinary at all!
And we are going to use these mirrors to show you exactly that.
And we're going to use them to get invisible.
Wait, what?
Yes, we're going to use them to get invisible later on.
No, like seriously? Like?
Yeah, we're going to set it up. But first, let's check out this quote from C.S. Lewis.
Oh, chicken strips.
There are no ordinary people. You have never talked to a mere mortal. Nations, cultures, arts, civilizations, these are mortal. And their life is to ours as the life of a gnat. But it is immortals whom we joke with, work with, marry, snub, and exploit. Immortal horrors or everlasting splendors.
Here's the deal. Me and you, we are more than ordinary. We're more than ordinary because we are made in the image of God. Just like C.S. Lewis said, we are an everlasting splendor. That means we are an eternal joy, not only to God, but to other people. We are made in the image of God. So what does that mean, right? What does it mean to be made in the image of God? I mean, we look like him. I mean, we smell like him. I mean, we sound like him. What does that really mean? And so this week, we're going to look at a video from the Bible Project that tells a little bit more about that.
People aren't to make images of God because God has already made images of himself.
When did he do that?
Well, let's go to page 1 of the Bible. And the first person we meet there is God. He's the one with authority over all creation. He speaks and creation obeys. And he defines what is good and not good. In other words, he alone is king. But then surprisingly, as the pinnacle of all of God's creative work, he makes humans, and he calls all of them the image of God.
Wait, so he gives all humans the authority to rule?
Exactly, that's what he goes on to say. He tells the humans to subdue the earth and to rule it. And so this task that once belonged only to elite kings is here in the Bible the task of every human being. This was a revolutionary statement in its day because all humans are being called to rule and to participate in the human project.
So what does this mean? I mean, how are we all supposed to rule?
So the picture we get in Genesis is gardening.
Gardening?
Yes. Gardening. So they rule the earth by cultivating it, by harnessing all of the earth's raw potential and then making something more and new out of it.
So growing food for each other.
Yes, but that also includes growing families then, which become neighborhoods. And then they create communities where people are going to work and take care of each other and build businesses and cities that will expand to new places and so on.
So ruling is really the day-to-day acts of our work and creativity.
Yes, we take the world somewhere. This is humanity's divine and sacred task. So this is the Bible's depiction of the human condition. So sometimes we pull off amazingly good stuff, but just as often, despite our best intentions, we act selfishly and we create evil in the world.
And so we're stuck as mediocre rulers making a mess of things.
But that's not the end of the story. So the Bible goes on and it makes this claim that all of this was resolved when God bound himself to humanity through Jesus. And he showed us what it looks like to truly rule as a human.
So what does it look like?
Well, Jesus ruled by serving and by seeking the best for others, by putting himself underneath them and loving not just his friends, but also his enemies.
And that's not a typical way to rule.
And not only that, Jesus confronted the consequences of all of the evil and the death that we have created by our messed up ways of ruling. And he takes it. I mean, he lets it kill him. And so when the New Testament writers looked back to Jesus' resurrection, they see a whole new future opening up for all humanity.
Jesus is a new way to be human.
Yeah, that's why they call Jesus the image of God, or the new human. And not only that, they also believe that Jesus' divine life and power is now available to heal and to transform us to become our life and power.
And this sounds really nice, but what does it really look like?
So practically, the Apostle Paul said it looks like people being filled by Jesus' own presence and spirit, filled with love and joy and peace and patience and kindness and goodness and integrity and gentleness and self-control. He says this is the new humanity that God wants to create in us so that we become people in whom God's image is being restored, people who will move the human project forward.
So, two big things I took away from that video about the image of God. Number one is that God is our creator. God is our creator. And so if we're made in his image, that means we are created to create. We are made to create times and opportunities that we can show Jesus through our lives. We do that by reflecting. We do that by reflecting on who Jesus is and what he did for us. We reflect it to others around us so that when people see us, they don't see us, they see Jesus. In Ephesians 5:8, it says, "For once you were full of darkness, but now you have light. So live as people of light." Live as you have something so bright to shine that you cannot contain it, because you do. Live as people who have something to shine to all, no matter what. Like, you have something to show and shine and reflect to everyone. The second thing is that we are all made in God's image. So that means you were made in his image, but that means the person sitting next to you was made in his image, and the person sitting next to that is made in his image, and the person you don't even know is made in God's image. And so it's time that we decide to see people the way that Jesus sees us, the way that God sees us, and that is in his image. Like, we all have something to offer, like we all have something to show, and like we all have something to shine. So we should shine that and treat people the way that they deserve to be treated.
Did it work, Jamie? Am I invisible?
You're gone!
Yay!
Yay, invisibly!
You did it.
No, but seriously.
Mm-hmm. Is it time to get invisible?
Yes!
For real?
Tis time!
Let's go!
Woohoo! And some of our loop shirts have laid out some tape for us, and they're
also here
to help as well. Aren't they lovely assistants? Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
So line the mirrors up on the line.
Okay.
Okay.
Clamps. All right. And I have this guy, and I have this guy. I feel like it was better on top.
Like this?
I don't know how that white piece worked.
That's probably an extra piece anyway. Okay. I definitely know how these work.
Ricky, do we really think that being invisible is worth all this work?
Listen, it's worth any amount of mirrors that we have to make happen.
Okay,
I think, is that still? Okay, so how does this make us invisible?
Okay, so these mirrors are going to reflect the light and create an optical illusion of you being invisible.
Okay.
I'm not totally sure, but I think maybe I need to stand here. Whoa, look, my body's gone. Invisible.
Jamie, where did you go?
Very cool.
this mirror is reflecting off of this mirror, which is reflecting off of this mirror, which is reflecting off of this mirror, which is reflecting this. And so you can only see the front mirror, which is this, and that makes you invisible. Jamie, oh no.
Going up, going up, going up, going up, going up. Going down, 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 down. So now that we have this, what would we do with our invisibility?
Win all of the hide and seek championships. Would you think to become like a superhero? Because that'd be very expensive and very delicate. It's just like, all right, everyone, wait, just give me a second. Let me just, all right, and you're gone. Okay, great, got it.
Whoa, oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh.
All right.
That's pretty neat.
You know what? We can just be waving to everyone.
Hey, I'm a wiggling. I'm dancing with my noodle arms.
Yes.
It looks like you're dancing.
So, if you are like these mirrors, what are you reflecting?
Okay, so like freshman year, I feel like was super easy for me to talk about Jesus with people like at school. And then for some reason over the summer, like I just got like a lack of courage a little bit. And then it was scary for me just to wear like my Life Church shirts to school. So it was even scarier for me to like actually go up to people and invite them to switch and invite them to church. And a lot of times youth pastors would come at lunch and I would give us out invites to hand out. And I would want to hand them out to people, but I was just always so scared. So I just always had stacks of invites laying in my backpack.
Alrighty, so here's my take on it because I've struggled with the same thing. As Christians, especially in a school kind of home church environment, we are a lot like billboards. People walk by us and people interact with us, you know, seconds at a time, maybe, you know, a quick hey there and a handshake there, high five there or something. And the way we interact with people briefly is in a way advertising or showing off how Jesus is inside of us and how we're wanting to reflect Jesus, if that makes sense. So for instance, you drive by a billboard and you see a quick flash of what they're advertising and you're like, oh, hey, that's what that company has. Well, you see, you know, you in the hallway and it's just a quick, hey, how are you? It's nice to see you. And it's just a quick advertisement of the kind of Christian you want to be, if that makes sense.
How do we know how to live like Jesus if he doesn't live in our time? So like, if you want to live like Selena Gomez, you can just look at her Instagram and like mimic that. But since Jesus doesn't live in our time, then how do we know how to reflect him or live like him?
I think the Bible has a lot more answers than we give it credit for. If you look at scripture, who did Jesus hang out with?
Broken, lost, lonely people.
Yeah, exactly. If you want the truth, too often I find myself striving for popularity, striving for the approval of people who I look up to. But when Jesus was here, I mean, he was going for the outcast and for the forgotten. And so I think if we really want to advertise that kind of billboard Christianity that we want, we need to be going for the lost and the broken.
A mirror can't generate its own light. It reflects whatever light is around it. You were made as a reflection of God. If I look at you, what would I see reflected? God or something else? Don't let anyone tell you that you were made for something else. You were made to shine the glory of God to the world around you. Get your light from the Lord and live as people of light. You are bright.
You're in my mirror. Can I get in your mirror?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm in your mirror. That was hard. Oh my gosh.
Remember, you are made in the image of God.
And so are the people next to you.
So remember, who are you reflecting?
Live as people of the light. And until next time, enjoy the ride.
You were created to reflect so much more than ordinary. You're created to reflect something special, something beautiful. You were created to reflect glory. So who or what are you reflecting to the world? Would you bow your heads and close your eyes as we pray together? Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time that we had today. I pray that each of us would ask ourselves the question, what or who are we reflecting to the world? Are we reflecting something ordinary, or are we reflecting something so much better? And I pray that we would choose the better thing, your glory. Still in an attitude of prayer with every head bowed and every eye closed, there are some of you who you're asking this question, and what you're realizing is that what's inside of you feels empty. And so when you're trying to figure out what you're reflecting, you have no idea because you've never even thought about this question before. That emptiness you're feeling is a result of something called sin. Every single one of us, we've all sinned. We've made choices that have hurt ourselves, others, or the heart of God. And that leaves us feeling empty and wanting more. But God, he loved you so much that he sent his son, Jesus, to die on a cross for your sins and for mine, to be the perfect sacrifice. And then on the third day, God raised Jesus from the dead so that anyone who believes in him would be saved, would be healed. And instead of reflecting emptiness, they would reflect God's glory to the world. And today you realize that that is what you've been missing, and that is what you've been wanting, a relationship with Jesus, to be made right with God. And if that's you, then you need to just simply lift your hand right now. If you're saying yes to Jesus today, we are so excited for you. And all together, we're gonna pray this prayer out loud, repeating after me. Dear Jesus, forgive me. I'm turning from my sin. I'm turning towards you. I need your love. I need your grace. I need your mercy. I give you my life. In Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. We are so proud of you and so excited for you as you begin this new journey of following Jesus. Before you leave, make sure you tell your small group leaders so they can help you understand what it means to be a follower of Jesus.
Welcome, welcome back, Impact iKidz. I hope you really enjoyed that message. I hope it was a blessing to you, as it was a blessing to me. Listen, continue to grow in the Word of God. Continue to watch these videos. Continue to spend time with Him. Continue to read His Word, because that's where growth really happens. And each week, we're going to continue to grow closer and closer to God and deeper into our relationship with Him. But let's just do a quick prayer. One, if you haven't accepted Christ and you would like to, let's make a prayer about that. And then secondly, let's just make a prayer that God just protects us throughout the weeks. So if you didn't accept Christ, let's make this prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we believe that your Son came down and he died for our sins. And because he died for our sins, whoever believes in their hearts and confesses with their mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord and Savior has everlasting life and they are saved. So God, we commit our hearts to you, God. We believe you died for our sins. We thank you for dying for our sins, God. And we believe that you are the Lord and Savior of our life. So God, we thank you and we accept you and we choose you today. In your name we pray, amen. Amen. If you made that prayer, send us an email. We would love to hear about it. And then secondly, let's make a prayer about protection. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for protecting us from things seen and unseen. God, I pray that you continue to protect us for the weeks to come, for the years to come, God. I pray that you just protect our family and friends from things seen and unseen, God. We thank you for your protection. We thank you for your love, God. We thank you for your favor. We thank you just for life, God. And we appreciate all that you do for us. We worship you and praise you. In your name we pray. Amen. Listen, if you made any of those two prayers, if you made the first prayer, let us know. We would love to hear from you and know that you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And secondly, if you made that second prayer, just continue to walk knowing that God is protecting you from things seen and unseen, trusting in him at all times. Amen? Amen. Listen, Impact, I will see you here next week. So tune in. Don't tune out. Tune in. Come back. Come back here. Sundays. We are here. We are alive. You need to come back or in person. Come back here or in person. Until then, I will see you here next week. Have a blessed week. You know what I'm about to say. I got to end it like that. I have to end the video like this. Go, iKidz. Woo! iKidz. Let's get it. Peace.